The halting problem is a computational problem that people have puzzled over for many years, and is a supposed proof that computers can't computationally or logically do everything. In the description, I will link a demonstration video, proof that computers can't do everything, the halting problem. But here's a quick summary. There's a negator machine N that gives the output of a smile if it receives the input stuck. And it gets, quote, stuck if it receives the input not stuck. Now that is fed by a machine H that tests if a machine would get stuck if fed with a blueprint of that machine and an input to that machine. Then this machine is fed by a machine that simply copies its input and duplicates it. So the blueprint and the input would be the same. Essentially, having machine fed with its own blueprint would be the simulation of machine H if hooked up in this way. So you wrap these machines into its own machine and label it X, with one input and one output, then feed it with its own blueprint. So whatever the middle machine says, stuck or not stuck, the bottom machine will supposedly get stuck or print a smiley face. Assuming the H machine says it would not get stuck, then it would supposedly get stuck. But assuming the H machine would say it would get stuck, it would print a smiley face. A supposed paradox. Now, while it may seem compelling on its face, the truth is that although it seems to be a proof, it's actually just an elaborate ruse. You see, they're twisting vocabulary and modes of operation in order to fit their conclusion into a box. The machine at the end, the end machine, is always working correctly, even when it supposedly gets stuck, because getting stuck is a programmed function of that very machine and not a glitch. Therefore, the middle machine, H, will always print not stuck, and the end machine will simply act as though it's stuck, when it's not really. Its output is simply to act as though it were stuck. Programmed malfunction is actually programmed function, because malfunction would mean that something is not working as intended. In more traditional language, if the machine does not halt, it is actually halting on the programmed function of looping, and the answer is obviously in the affirmative. Machines don't think, they do the job they're programmed to do. And the halting machine, with a negator, is programmed to halt at the answer of looping. There is no paradox. For those who might say, well, you just don't understand the problem, or those aren't the rules, then you're just playing a game. You're not interested in real logic or solving real problems, because anyone who understood the X machine or the H plus machine or whatever you want to call it would know that a continuous looping or getting stuck out of that machine would indicate that the test was a pass and could functionally use that output, even if it was just a continuous series of binary ones. You're interested in games, not the truth. The halting problem is a hoax.